Hi, hello friends. In front of you, I am Raju, pursuing 10th class from TTWREIS Boys, Adilabad. So today I am here to present a wonderful lesson from the branch of physical science. So before going to start about our lesson, I want to introduce my lesson. So friends, in our day-to-day life, we are eating different types of vegetables and we are eating different types of fruits. In that, there is a presence of acid, bases and salts. Yes, today we are going to learn about acid, bases and salts in our lesson. So friends, first of all, we have to know what is meant by acid, base and salts. So friends, the word acid derived from Latin word that acidus. The acidus stands for so. The things which are sour in taste and turns blue litmus to red litmus are known as acids. And friends, when we come to bases, the bases are bitter to taste. The things which are bitter to taste and turns red litmus to blue litmus are known as bases. So friends, when we come to salts, so salts are neutral. When acid reacts with base, salts are produced. So today we are going to learn about acid, bases and salts in our lesson. So today I am going to explain few subtopics in my lesson, that acid, bases and salt, chemical properties of acid, base and salt, reaction of acid with metal, reaction of acid with carbonates and metal hydrogen carbonates, reaction of acid with metal oxide, neutralization reaction, strength of the acid, conduction of electricity with acidic solution. So today we are going to learn these all things in our lesson. So after completion of lesson, you are able to learn these all things. So friends, now I am going to explain about acid. So friends, I already explained that acids are derived from Latin word, that means acidus. The word acidus stands for sour. The things which are sour in taste and turns blue litmus to red litmus are known as acids. So let us recall what is meant by base. So friends, base. The base are bitter to taste. The things which are bitter to taste and turns red litmus to blue litmus are known as bases. So friends, mainly acid are divided into two types, that organic acid and inorganic acid. Now I am going to explain about organic acid. Organic acid are produced from animals and plants. So friends, organic acids are useful for manufacture of chemicals and medicine. And organic acids are very weak acid. So for example, like citric acid, formic acid and acetic acid, these all are examples for weak acids. So friends, now I am going to explain about inorganic acid. Inorganic acids are produced from minerals. Oh, inorganic acids are not contain carbon. And inorganic acids are useful for fertilizers and paints and manufacturers of textile, synthetic textile. And inorganic acids are strong acid. For example, like sulfuric acid, hydrochloric acid, nitric acid. These all are examples for strong acids. So friends, next I am going to explain about chemical properties of acids. So acids are sour to taste. So friends, if we taste acids, so acids are sour to taste and acids turns blue litmus to red litmus. So for example friends, here I am taking hydrochloric acid. So if we dip blue litmus paper in hydrochloric acid, it turns into a red color. If it turns into a red color, then it is acid. If it turns into a blue color, it is a base. So friends, here it turns into a red color. So blue litmus paper turns into a red litmus paper, it known as acid. So friends, an acid. So if you add methyl orange in acid, so it is acid, hydrochloric acid. If it add methyl orange in acid, it turns into a red color. If it turns into a red color, it is acid. So I am adding methyl orange into acid. So friends, it turning into a red color. So it is acid. So when we add methyl orange to acid, then it turns into a red color. So the things which if we add a methyl orange, it turns into a red color and acid turns blue litmus to red litmus. So next, acids are soluble in a water and it's release H plus ion. Acids are good conductor of electricity. Acids liberate heat. So when we dilute acid, it liberate heat. This process is known as exothermic reaction. And friends, next, reaction of acid with metal. So when acid reacts with metal, it produces salt plus hydrogen gas. So in this process, it liberates hydrogen gas. So friends, when for example, let me take conical flask. So I am taking one conical flask and I am adding dilute hydrochloric acid. So when we add dilute hydrochloric acid, it is acid, dilute hydrochloric acid. So for that, let us add zinc. Zinc is a metal. So when we add metal to acid, so friends, I am adding metal to acid. So then it produces salts plus hydrogen gas. It liberates hydrogen gas. To indicate hydrogen gas is liberating, so we have to use a burning glowing matchstick near a top of the conical flask. When we bring the burning matchstick near the top of the conical flask, then automatically when gas liberate, if we bring a glowing matchstick near a conical flask, then it gives pop sound and automatically fire will be off. So friends, so let us add again hydrochloric acid to liberate hydrogen gas. I am adding metal zinc. So zinc is a metal. So it liberating hydrochloric acid. So after few times, let us observe this activity. Next, I am going to explain about reaction of acid with carbonates and metal hydrogen carbonate. So the main aim of this activity is that when CO2 is liberated, when CO2 enters in a calcium hydroxide, then it changes into a milky white, it forms precipitate. So for this, we have to take one stand. After taking a stand, we have to label that. We have to take two test tubes. In one test tube, we have to add sodium carbonate, and another test tube, we have to add sodium hydrogen carbonate. So for these two test tubes, we have to name as AB test tube. After naming AB test tube, in this both test tube, we have to add hydrochloric acid. So after adding a hydrochloric acid, it liberates CO2. So when it liberates CO2 gas, so for that, we have to put one cork. So by delivery tube, we have to delivery tube process. So from this, CO2 gas passes to delivery tube and enters in a calcium hydroxide. Then it forms precipitate. So with this activity, we can know that when CO2 enters in a calcium hydroxide, it forms as precipitate. And friends, next, I am going to explain about reaction of acid with metal. So when acid reacts with metal, it produces salts plus water. So friends, the main aim of this, so for this, I am going to take metal oxide plus acid. So when metal oxide reacts with acid, so they produce salts plus water. So friends, for this, if you take a zinc oxide, when zinc oxide reacts with hydrochloric acid, it produces salt plus water. So friends, this is a main aim of this activity. And next, neutralization reaction. So actually, if you are with acid, so for neutralizing acid, so we have to use base. If acid falls on a ground, we can neutral with a base. So if acid falls on a ground, we have to pour a base. When we pour a base, then with that, acid will be neutral. So friends, for this, we have to take acid. Acid plus base, it gives salts plus water. So for this, if you take a hydrochloric acid plus sodium hydroxide. Hydrochloric acid plus sodium hydroxide, it gives NaCl plus H2O. It gives salts plus water. Okay friends, let us observe this pop sound activity. So it liberating H2. So when it liberate H2, so it liberating a gas. So when a glowing matchstick we put near a test tube, it gives pop sound and it's automatically off. So friends, observe here. So when this liberate, so when H2 is liberate, it gives pop sound. So with this, we can indicate that when acid reacts with base, so it gives pop sound. So to indicate this, we done this activity. So next, I am going to explain about neutralization reaction. When acid reacts with base, it gives salts plus water. So friends, at the morning we are waking and we are brushing our teeth. Do you know why we are brushing our teeth? To neutral our teeth. So in morning, in night. In our mouth, acid will be released. So to neutral acid, we are using base. Base, the paste is a base. So when we brush with the paste, it neutral our teeth. So this is the main aim of this neutralization reaction. And removing water from copper sulfate. So for this, we have to take one burner. After taking a burner, we have to take one test tube and test tube holder. In this, we have to add copper sulfate. So the main aim of this activity is that to prove that copper sulfate has 5 hydrate of water molecules. So when we heat this copper sulfate, it evaporates 5 hydrate of water molecules and it changes into a white color. So after adding 2 drops of water in test tube, it again changes into a blue color. Let us do this activity, friends. So friends, for this I am taking one burner. I am adding copper sulfate. So I am taking here test tube and I am adding copper sulfate, few amount of copper sulfate. When you add this copper sulfate, so copper sulfate is a in blue color. So if you heat this copper sulfate, it changes into a white color. It evaporates its 5 hydrate of water molecules. So observe here. So friends, for this we have to take mainly burner. After taking a burner, we have to take test tube. So then we observe that this copper sulfate evaporate 5 hydrates of water molecules and it form bubble in test tube. When it form bubbles in a test tube, we can know that. So here, observe here, it evaporating 5 hydrates of water molecules. So after evaporating, it change into a white color. So for this we have to take one burner, test tube and test tube holder. So when we heat this copper sulfate, it evaporate 5 hydrate of water. So observe here friends, it's changing into a white color. So we have to heat this. After heating this, see, observe here, it's changing into a white color. So when it's changing into a white color, again we have to add 5 hydrate of water molecule, or if you add water to this, so again it changes into a blue color. So if you add a 5 hydrate of water molecule, then again it changes into a blue color. Observe here friends, when I am heating, it's changing into a white color. So it evaporating its 5 hydrate of water molecule. So it changed into a white color friends. If I add a 5 hydrate of water molecule, so I am adding 5 hydrate of water molecule to it. See friends, it changed into a, so it changed into a white color too. Again it changed into a blue color. So friends, this is the main aim of this activity. And friends, now next I am going to explain about strength of the acid and base. So friends, next I am going to explain about strength of the acid and base. With help of universal indicator, we can know that the strength of the acid and strength of the base. So universal indicator is made of a mixture of several indicator. So this universal indicator shows that pH value of acid and bases at different position, at different color, it shows different concentration of a acid and base. So for this we have to take, so we know that hydrochloric acid is a strong acid. But friends, I think in your mind one question is raising that if hydrochloric acid is a strong acid, then sulfuric acid, so actually sulfuric acid is the king of the acid, then why hydrochloric acid is a strong acid? Because the main aim of this, main aim is that this hydrochloric acid liberate more H plus ion when comparing to sulfuric acid. So hydrochloric acid is a strong of the acid. So friends, when we come to bases, in bases the strong base is that sodium hydroxide. And friends, next pH paper. We know that pH paper shows that strength of the acid. It shows that pH value of acid, bases and salts at a different position, at a different color, it shows different concentration. So friends, if we come to 0 to 6, it shows 0 to 6, it shows that concentration of acid. If we come 0, so 0 is a strong acid. If we come 6, 6 is a weak acid. So friends, 7 is a neutral. 7 indicates that the pH value of 7 indicates that neutral. When we come 8 to 14 shows that bases. So the pH value of bases. When we come 14 indicates that strong base, and 8 indicates that weak base. And friends, next, now I am going to explain conduction of electricity with acidic solution. So we can conduct electricity with acidic solution. So we prepare a battery with acidic solution. We also conduct electricity with acidic solution. So friends, for this we need that one beaker, and we have to add hydrochloric acid. After adding hydrochloric acid to it, so we have to label one circuit, label to it. So with the graphites, we have to dip the graphites in hydrochloric acid. After that, automatically lights will on. So with this acidic solution, we can conduct electricity also. Okay, friends, next. So friends, in observing a slide, we are observing that so many pictures in a slide. So we don't know which are bases, which are salts. So let us classify which are a base, which are acids, and which are salts. So friends, so in this image, the person feeling so. So the things which are so to taste and turns blue litmus to red litmus are known as acids. And in this image, the person feeling bitter to taste, the things which are bitter to taste and turns blue litmus, red litmus to blue litmus are known as bases. So friends, and for salt, so observing this image, he feeling that so, the person feeling, the small child feeling so to taste. So our scientists were classified acid, bases and salts as depend on their taste. So if the things are which are so to taste, they classified as acids, the things which are bitter to taste, they classified as bases. In this image, the person feeling salty to taste, the things which are salty, they classified as salts. So observe two examples. So friends, so they classified as acid, bases and salts and depend on the taste. Our scientists were classified acid, bases and salts and depend on their taste. So for example, if you take, I think in your mind one question is raising that if why the salt, why the sugar is kept in a side? Because the main reason is that sugar is nor an acid, nor a base, nor a salt. Because sugar is having its separate group. So in this class today we discussed that acid, bases and salts. So bases, when we come to bases, so bases are bitter to taste and turns red litmus to blue litmus. So if we add a bases to methyl orange, it change into a pink color. So let us observe, friends. So it is a sodium hydroxide. So when I dip red litmus paper in this sodium hydroxide, it's changed into a blue color. If it is changed into a blue color, then it is a base. Observe. So friends, it's changing into a blue color. The things if we add litmus paper, red litmus paper in base, it's changed into a blue color. So if you add a phenolphthalein to base, it's changed into a pink color. If it is changed into a pink color, then it base. See friends, it's changing into a pink color. So with this we can know that if we add a phenolphthalein to base, it's changed into a pink color. If you add methyl orange to base, if you add methyl orange to acid, it's changing to a red color. So this is the main aim of this activity. And friends, when we come to chemical properties of acid, bases and salts, so acids are so to taste and turns blue litmus to red litmus, and acids are mainly two types, that organic acid and inorganic acid. So organic acids are useful for manufacture of chemicals, and these are produced from animals and plants. When we come to inorganic acids are strong acid. For example, like sulfuric acid, hydrochloric acid, nitric acid, these all are example for strong acid. And friends, if we come to reaction, neutralization reaction, the name aim of this neutralization reaction is that to neutralize acid. So to neutral the acid, we have to use a base. So if ants bites on our hand, so we use this base. So base to control our hand pain. So ants are release few chemicals on our hands. So to control the pain, we have to use a base. When we use this base, so it will be neutral acids. It will be neutral acids and its form salts plus water. And friends, when we come to this Popson activity, when we add hydrochloric acid to it, then hydrochloric acid, after adding hydrochloric acid, we have to add metal. When we add metal, it reacts with metal. I added that metal, zinc. So when zinc reacts with hydrochloric acid, it's produced salts plus water. So friends, it's given that pop sound. So if it is given a pop sound, so it indicating that hydrochloric acid is releasing. When hydrochloric acid release, it give pop sound and it automatically off. Again, let one again observe. So friends, when we come to neutralize, I already explained about a neutralization reaction. So this neutralization reaction is mainly useful in our day-to-day life. And friends, I explained about a carbon dioxide. When carbon dioxide release, the indicator of carbon dioxide is that, so when carbon dioxide enters in a calcium hydroxide, it forms a precipitate and it changes into a milky white. And friends, so in this class we learn about acid bases and salts, chemical properties of acid bases and salts, neutralization reaction, acid reacts with metal, and acid reacts with carbonates and metal hydrogen carbonates, and strength of the acid and strength of the base, conduction of electricity with acidic solution. So these are useful in our daily life. So friends, actually if you are with acid, and if you saw in a markets, or if the few peoples are believe that superstition. So with this superstition, we are believing superstition, and so we have to believe a science. So in this superstition, they use that acid bases and salts because they use lemon. So when they cut lemon, it changes into a red color. So for this, in this lemon, there is a present of citric acid. So this lemon, if you add a methyl orange to lemon, so it changes into a red color. So for this, we are believing that blood is releasing. So friends, if you believe a superstition, so superstitions all are depend on a acid bases and salts. So friends, this all activities are mainly useful in our day-to-day life. Okay friends, thank you for giving this 191 golden opportunity to share my views on this lesson. My special thanks goes to R.S. Prime Kumar sir, and my thanks goes to Principal P. Augustine Sargaru and staff teachers and guide teacher Sujata Madam Rashik Reddy sir, Madhurao sir, and my thanks goes to Ramarao sir, Nageshwarao sir, and Sharma sir to helping me. Okay, thank you for giving this 191 golden opportunity.